Just to point out that about 80% of the African countries actually don't have legal abortion. And they don't have legal abortion not because they can't legalize abortion. We all have parliaments, we have governments that can go through the process of legalizing abortion. But actually, an overwhelming majority of the African people continue to reject abortion, even as surveys, you know, I think Pew Research had done a survey a couple of years ago and found out, I mean, in some countries, as high as 90-something% of the people still continue to reject the idea of legalized abortion. So I don't understand, are we talking about abortion? Are we talking about contraception? They're two different things. If we're talking about abortion, well, I don't think that any Western country has a right to pay for abortions. In an African country, especially where majority of people don't want abortion, then that then becomes a form of ideological colonization, as we're beginning to see it more and
more. But say if we talk about contraception, the fact remains that hundreds of millions of women don't have access and should.
Well, you're saying should, but who are you to decide if you don't mind me saying?
Well, because
there isn't a popular demand, ma'am. There isn't a popular demand. If you go to Africa, what people are asking for every day, because I was born in Africa, I was raised in Africa, I continue to go to Africa many times a year. You just speak to any ordinary woman. I think contraception might be like the 10th thing she says, if that.
But it's a basic human right to have access to it. That's when I say that they should have access. It should become available for them if they want it.
When
it should be
available.
When there
is no food and there is no water, then if there is
and
only a limited amount
cycle.
Of aid.
But well, it is part of that cycle of poverty and dealing with poverty and overcoming poverty, is it not?
Well, that's kind of a Western solution, isn't it? But if the Africans are brought to the table, and the people are asked, the ordinary people, I'm not speaking about some doctor that works for some Western organization that is planted in Africa. If you speak to the ordinary woman on the streets of Africa, what is she asking for? She's asking for food. She's asking for water. She's asking for basic health care. And contraception continues to be like about the last thing that they would ever think of.
But does
now
that
talking
not,
about contraception,
does
sorry.
That, but does that not play into the wider conversation about poverty and food? If they have access to contraception, if they can deal with birth control, if they can have a family planning program in place, then it deals with the issues of poverty as
that
well.
That is the Western solution. Why don't you listen to the people first? Now, talking about something like contraception, in all this talk about contraception, the one thing that I have never heard of in all my time trying to track all these things is something like the side effects of contraception. No one ever tells the African women when they come to promote contraception across the different African countries. No one talks about it. Now, recently, I spoke to some women in Africa who had contraception inserted into them. I think it was something like the IUD and the Implanon. And these women were crying. I found myself consoling women who had actually been experiencing in these side effects that they had never heard of before. No one ever told them. But someone from a Western organization, one of these Western organizations in Africa, came and put IUDs into them and told them, this is what you need to come out of poverty. That is not what African women need. That is not the single indicator to come out of poverty. What Africans need is education.
They
it's
do, indeed.
It's good governance.
About education
kind of
as well, so that they understand their basic human rights. It's not just about the West coming
rights,
and imposing
you,
something.
These are colonial thoughts, so you better be careful expressing them. According to whom? So Africans, there are Africans who don't have access to education. What children are looking for is a way to get into school. Someone like myself, I was born in Africa, I was raised in Africa. My lifeline out of poverty was education. It was not contraception. And there are so many other women who have walked the same path as I have without ever having to take recourse to some contraception provided by the British government or the United States government.
So you're then also generalizing, speaking on behalf of, you know, every woman on the continent,
well,
saying
so
that the
you.
Majority of
so
them.
So are you? You're talking about a general solution when Africa is actually not a monolithic society.
All I'm saying is that they should have the right to have access to.
Well, they do. We have contraception in Africa. As a matter of fact, a lot of the aid money is being actually redirected to provision of things like contraception.
Well, when the United Nations says that more than 200 million women don't have access to it, you know, then
well,
that's contradicting
how many,
what you're saying.
How many of those people? I am not contradicting them. I'm saying these are the calculations by the United Nations. But how many of those 200 million women are actually asking for it. There is a difference between what the United Nations now calls the unmet need and the unmet demand. What the African women are actually dying
of. When we go back to education, perhaps they're unaware.
Well, it's for someone like yourself, you know, someone so kind and generous from the West to come tell them that what they need is contraception to come out of poverty. Now you give them contraception, and the next day they still don't have work. The following year they still don't have work.
I would really love to discuss this further with you. We're just 10 seconds to go off air. So thank you very much for joining.
Thank you
very much for joining us here on the program. Do stay with us. We've got lots more coming.